GL Flex here, and I'm just giving an update on top surgery and how I'm looking. So I am officially 4 months post-op, post-operative. So 4 months past the surgery, past top surgery. As you can see, I had the double incision, double mastectomy. So they cut from here across. They didn't go up here, which was really dope. I really appreciate how my surgeon, I think it's Dr. Robert Harris Gilman, Dr. Gilman at the University of Michigan Health Systems. I love how with his technique, he cuts underneath. He doesn't cut all the way up. I appreciate that. This is how I'm looking. Oh, and I'm, you know, of course, hairy armpits, the whole nine yard, but that's how I'm looking. It's you know, relatively flat. The nipples, I do feel my nipples. Like, if I rub my finger over them, I feel them. So I'm really appreciative of that, because there's so many situations from other people who have had similar procedures where they were unable to get their nipple sensation back. I feel my nipples. I also was able to get my color pigmentation back. I was very worried about that, because initially when they removed the stitches and I was able to finally see everything and they removed the nipple gauzes and stuff, the skin started falling off, but that was because it was healing. You gotta give it time to heal, so don't rush to thinking that your skin pigmentation won't come back. It may come back. It more than likely will come back. And disclaimer, there is an opportunity for you to get your nipples tattooed so they can get tattooed back to your original color and shading. Here's my other pec. Now this pec over here, if you notice, is slightly bigger than my left pec. My right pec had the hematoma. And if you follow me on Instagram, GeoFox, I did upload a picture showing like how this originally looked. So trigger warning, there will be stitches, blood, needles, scarring, etc. So when you go on. So you do notice that this is slightly bigger. This was like huge, like it was like a balloon. That's how much blood and fluid did not properly drain. Now mind you, I had 2 JP drains, okay? I had 2 of them. The left one drained very well, no problems whatsoever. The right drain was not draining enough. That's why I ended up having a hematoma, and it was just like blood, dry blood, fluid that should have been drained by the JP drains. Me personally, I am not a fan of JP drains. I really don't get the purpose of them, especially when you still end up having complications that you shouldn't be getting in the first place. I'm just putting it out there. Me personally, I would recommend looking at surgeons who have other techniques, because there are surgeons who do not use the JP drains. This is slightly bigger. As you can see, there's extra skin here. There's a little dog ear. And I am scheduled to go back to see my surgeon and the PA next month in April to discuss revision surgery options. And just from discussing with other people and other trans men who've had this procedure, shout out to my trans brothers and trans masculine and folks out there who have had this procedure. We are strong individuals, point blank period. Yeah, one of my brothers literally was like, yeah, just go on and get that revision. Try not to eat a long amount of time, because you just wanna get that stuff out the way so you can actually heal completely instead of going back and forth. Because like, I had to wear a compression vest for 4 months because of the hematoma. Normally 6 to 8 weeks, and then you can go on about your life. Me, I ended up having to do this for 12 weeks. So, or 16 weeks. So it was a lot, you know what I mean? So yeah, so it's slightly bigger. When you see the before pics, this went down tremendously. And me personally, I am very much thankful, grateful, privileged, blessed, and pleased with how this went down. Because if you would have seen how this looked before,
like I said, it looked like I had a balloon, like I had like an AB cup. Like, honestly, it was very wild. But ironically enough, I did not have a lot of pain, which is another reason why I didn't really complain about it. And then when we went back for my follow-up visit and they removed it and they saw it, because I didn't even know what it looked like, that's when everybody was like, oh my God. And I'm like, you didn't feel anything? And I'm like, no. And this side is still like relatively numb, like dead. It's still kind of numb over here and on my back.
Here's the scar. Again, I appreciate how Dr. Hillman cuts under like that. Side angle, it's not like super, like to me. Yes, we're gonna, you know, granted, if the opportunity to get the revision and have it more symmetric, granted, I am gonna want that. So we're gonna take out this extra skin here, because there's a lot of extra, you know, there's extra skin that's just not over here on this side that's over here. So they're gonna take it back and kind of push it back so these are more symmetric, right? So I get that. I'm also working on building muscle, because like a lot of us, when you get top surgery, or if you are looking to get top surgery, I want to put a disclaimer. Every trans man, trans masculine person, non-binary, gender fluid person, everybody doesn't get surgeries. Everyone doesn't get on hormones. That's not everybody's path, everybody's journey. It's not what everybody wants. So please understand that. I wanted top surgery for me because I have gender dysphoria, and for me, it really helped alleviate gender dysphoria when it came to my top. And ironically enough, I don't really have a lot of bottom dysphoria. I had a lot of top dysphoria. And I think a reason why I don't really have that much bottom dysphoria, a lot of it is because I'm intersex. So I already have equipment that I'm fine with. And then two, when I look at myself as a sexual being, I tend to be a bottom. So I don't necessarily need you know, certain things in the first place, but that's just for me. There are people who have severe bottom dysphoria, and there are people who will get bottom surgery, right? There are people who do get those surgeries. Me personally, I'm not really impressed with the science and the medical procedures, and I'm also not impressed with how long bottom surgery can be, because like there's people who will end up spending 5 years to complete bottom surgery. That's a lot of time, a lot of money. Do you have health insurance coverage? What are they covering? How are you healing? How are you resting? And there's a lot of complications with bottom surgery that I personally am not interested in. And again, the science, in my opinion, is not there. It's improving. It has improved amazingly, you know, over the last 50, 60 years. But if I'm going to be putting that much time, energy into healing and recovering and everything else, I want to get something that looks like something I want to have on my body. That's just me personally, to each his own. So, and like I said, I'm already having complications with this, so I'm just gonna take my time. But this is how I'm looking. Now, what I want to do, like I said, I have the body of a 13, 14 year old teenage boy, preteen boy, and I'm not really 100% pleased with that, and a lot of that is gender dysphoria, body dysmorphia, the whole nine yards, bad body imaging. And I get that. And then also, you can want to make improvements and make changes. So one of those improvements, changes for me is, as you can see, I need to lift weights. That's really what it all boils down to. You know, I'm 146 pounds right now, but I literally fluctuate between 139 and 146 pounds all the time. I'll work really hard to gain weight so I can while I'm lifting weights, so I can build muscle, and then I fall off, I'm not eating enough, I'm not lifting enough, and I go right back to the 130s. So about 139-ish. So I'm trying to be careful not to keep falling off, because I don't want to lose more weight. I just want to tone up and build muscle and have a solid size
if that makes any sense. Because right now, I'm just like, I feel like I could have, you know, way more muscle definition, like right now. Like if I'm flexing, this is me flexing. You know, I mean, I could have way more muscle definition, in my opinion. So that's what I'm working on. But anyways, all have a good day, and there will be more footage, more video discussions, hopefully more guests and people who can share their perspectives in a respectful manner. GeoFox, the channel is definitely going to be more consistent, as you've seen. Shout out to Mr. Westenizer for being a wonderful friend, supporter, content creator, fellow YouTuber. I love doing videos with Mr. Westenizer, so you will definitely see more collaboration on both of our channels. We're gonna get there. We're gonna get, oh, and like I was saying earlier, you will notice you're going to lose butt. Like, I do not have the same booty that I had previously. Let's just say that. Like, I don't, like, again, I went from being at, when I was seriously into weight training and weightlifting and powerlifting, I went from being 220 to 146. So that's why I'm like, it's a lot of work, weight training, powerlifting, and like consistently doing that, because like you go through stages where you have to bulk. So like I would literally spend fall and winter bulking, which is essentially binge eating in many cases, and just lifting nonstop, trying to get my going up in pounds, going up in my reps and how many sets I can do, and that was my focus. And then I would spend spring and summer basically cutting. So like now you're on a calorie deficit because you're trying to lose body fat so you can lean out. So then like that's your whole spring and summer. So it's like 6 months binge eating, lifting heavy, bulking, and then 6 months dieting, calorie deficit, a lot of cardio, trying to lean out, and then still lifting, but like moderate lifts. And it's like, so I would go from being 220, you know, at my heaviest, to like between 185 and 200 once I finished my cut. This is by far the craziest cut I've ever had, but that's also because I have Graves' disease, IBS, and my metabolism is essentially like caffeinated. It's an overdrive for no reason. Because like I literally can eat, like I've done it numerous times, I'll just binge eat and I'll have like a whole pizza to myself, not gain a single pound, throw up, be sick as hell, and it's just not good for me anymore. So I just stopped doing a lot of that, hence why I went from being 220 to 146. And now I'm trying to, I don't want to go back to that unhealthy, you know, negative body imaging and like binge eating and doing things that just for me personally are not really healthy. Like, I don't want to do that, but I do want to have a healthy lifestyle and like still want to lift weights and, you know, have more muscle definition, but in a healthy way versus how I was previously. But anyways, I just wanted to give an update. This is how I'm looking. More stuff will be coming in the pipeline. Stay tuned, and I'm out.